All right, I'm going to go ahead and start recording because this is comedy gold.
Yeah.
Don't sweat the small stuff, Darren. That's what I've learned.
Mm-hmm.
Are you, you're not, I hope you're not over there sweating the small stuff.
No, I'm not sweating at all. Okay. Cool as a cucumber.
Let me remind you, this is only an exhibition. This is not a competition. Please, no wagering.
Welcome to Irritable Dad Syndrome. If you had a podcast, we'd listen to yours. Please welcome your hosts, Mike and Darren.
Hey, everybody, I'm Darren.
I am Mike.
Welcome to Irritable Dad Syndrome. This is episode 99. Now, tonight we're going to party like it's episode 99.
I'm excited.
Yeah?
Why? Episode 99. Mm-hmm. This is the last episode
in the double digits.
In the double digits.
Yeah, I know.
After this, it's a three-digit podcast.
It's all triple-digit podcast.
Triple-digit.
Yep.
When I very first began listening to podcasts, mm-hmm. That's a terrible sentence, but I'm going to keep it.
Okay.
I remember listening to a podcast, and it had 150 episodes, and I thought, wow.
Wow.
That is a major podcast.
They know their stuff.
They know their stuff.
They've talked a lot.
Yeah.
They keep going.
And we're 50 episodes from that.
Yeah. Math. Your ability to do math on the spot has always impressed me.
150 minus X equals 100. X equals 50. That is your algebraic lesson for this evening.
Yeah.
What happened?
Hey, what happened?
Tonight on the show, I just got back from a vacation in Hilton Head, and I'm going to talk a little bit about that.
I was involved in an assault on a wasp nest in the poopy tree.
Yeah, yeah. And my son had his wisdom teeth pulled out.
Yeah. And we are going to retire a song that we both really enjoy.
Yeah. Before we do that, I want to talk about something very serious. A very good friend of mine who I used to work with at WLWT, his name is Bill Hager, and he passed away unexpectedly, 51 years old.
Oh, my God.
He was on the Loveland bike trail,
yeah,
and he had a heart attack. And he, unfortunately, has passed away. Hmm. Blew my mind. I got a call from a friend of mine, Carrie.
Mm-hmm.
And Carrie doesn't call me unless someone's dead.
Sounds like a great friend. Yeah, so when the phone rings and her name pops up.
She is a good friend. But we have, my former boss had recently had surgery. And so I got a call from Carrie and I thought, oh, something's happened to Pete. And I answered the phone frantically. I'm like, hey, what's going on? And turns out someone had died, but it wasn't Pete. It was our friend Bill. Yeah. And here's the thing about Bill. Oh, my God. He was the managing editor in the newsroom at WLWT Channel 5. This guy knew his stuff. I mean, he really, really knew his stuff down to the bare bones. I mean, every reporter he worked with, he made them a better reporter. Every anchor became a better anchor. Every producer became a better producer. Even the news directors who ran the flipping news department became better because of Bill Hager.
Okay.
But the thing was, Bill knew everything there was to know about politics and journalism. He also had a killer sense of humor. He was a big fan of this podcast.
Really?
Yeah. He liked our podcast very much.
Yeah.
And whenever I'd walk through the newsroom, he would stop me and say, hey, that was hilarious what you guys were doing. And Mike talks about you too a lot. I'm like, I know. I'm talking to him about that. Yeah. Anyway, Bill had a great sense of humor, and there was a producer who left.
You listened to this podcast, yet he had a great sense of humor.
Okay. Yeah. So there was a producer who left the station a couple months ago, and as a going away present, he had a dartboard made for this guy with Bill's picture in the center, the bullseye, and there were these quotes that Bill would give this guy when he critiqued his writing style.
Okay.
He would say, looks like a randomly dumped can of alphabet soup. 2 out of 10, would not recommend. Doesn't suck as bad as I thought it would. Did not make my eyes bleed. These are perfect. Let's drain the pus from the wound.
Okay.
Most words are spelled correctly. Not overly embarrassing. And I'm disappointed in your writing. And your tears are the only joy in my cold, cold heart.
Okay.
This is what's all on this dartboard that he made for this producer he was leaving. Bill Hager was a fantastic guy. I'm just so sorry that he's gone. Yeah. And I wanted to mention him. And I wanted to, you know, the cool thing was the last time I saw him was a couple weeks ago at a going away party for another friend of ours. We laughed. And it's like, I never had a bad moment with this guy. Never had a disagreement. Never had an argument.
Yeah.
Never had a crossword. And so I'm sad that he's gone, and the world lost a great guy in Bill Hager. And let's get on with the show.
We need to address something.
What's that?
The show, and it's not on the rundown, but I do need to address it right now.
Yeah.
There, I don't know if you know about this. There's a virus running rampant throughout the world.
Yeah.
The vid.
Oh, COVID. Yeah. I heard about that. It's called a pandemic.
Yeah. So what has happened is that I have managed to avoid the COVID for years.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
And just last week, I got the COVID.
I thought you had it once.
I thought I did.
Okay.
But after actually getting it, I realize I don't think I've ever had it.
Okay.
Because but what then, I went through before weren't like this.
Right.
I was freezing and had a temperature of 100.4.
Ooh.
Freezing.
Yeah.
Could not get warm.
You had chills and fever.
I would be in bed and I would put one sheet on me. Immediately break out into sweat.
Yes.
And I was so hot I couldn't breathe.
Yeah.
Take the sheet off. I'm shaking uncontrollably.
Mm-hmm.
I was like that from 5 p.m. The day that I came home with that until probably 10 p.m. the following night.
Yep.
And then after that, I was really tired.
Yeah.
And the reason I'm talking about this is I don't have the vid anymore, hence we're here
in the
compound B.
Right. Studio B.
Studio B. However, I coughed a lot.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I know.
I coughed more than you roll your eyes at the prequels.
That's a lot.
I coughed so much. I coughed myself to sleep. I coughed while I was asleep. I coughed myself awake.
Yeah.
I coughed while peeing.
Yeah.
I do not recommend that. I coughed while taking a It helps to further expel the bowels, but it is painful.
Cut,
and you risk a prolapse.
Cut.
All right.
We're starting the show over.
Let me remind you, this is only an exhibition. This is not a competition. Please, no wagering.
Welcome to Irritable Dad Syndrome.
I coughed while coughing.
Yeah.
I think I've torn things all down through my... That's your respiratory system, Darren. I don't know if you know this. That's your respiratory system.
I know a little bit about the body.
And I've torn things, and they are irritated. And now I will randomly go into non-productive, raspy coughs. And I apologize.
Yeah.
I try to stop them. I try to put my head off to the side when I cough during the podcast because we can't afford a cough button because we don't have enough patrons because people don't care enough about the show.
Yeah.
To
contribute people who don't contribute financially.
So they get to hear me hack and cough and fart.
Yeah. You've never farted on this show.
I farted on
this
show.
Well, that we've heard.
Astute listeners will if anybody can bring back every time, give me the episode and the timestamp every time Mike has farted on the show, you'll win a prize. It's our first contest.
Okay. We had a contest.
Yeah, second contest.
Robert Hill won the UHF DVD.
He did. So I'm apologizing to our listeners in advance. I'm not trying to do it. I can't help it. I've been fighting back a cough through this entire monologue.
Yeah.
So.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're feeling better.
Thank you. You ever had a cough so hard that you create a floater and you see it happen and it just goes? That's every cough I have right now. That I just created a floater when I did that.
There were there have been many years in a row where I have had bronchitis, strep throat, and two ear infections at the same time. Usually I get the whole package.
Yeah.
Okay. I go in the doctor, give me something for all of them. They give me the CPAC, they give me the steroids, they give me the cough medicine with the stuff in it, the really good stuff.
Yeah.
And but there was one
time. It's like you got a supervisor in your chest and he's saying, "We're shutting everything from here north down."
Exactly. Yeah. Shut it down. But I've coughed so hard that I've blacked out. Seriously, you cough so hard and you can't see. Like, I can't see.
Yeah.
I've never coughed myself blind, but that's what's happened. You know, it's bad.
Yeah.
It's really, really bad. Anyway, I'm glad the vid has left your body.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I hope it did. Otherwise, you're going to get it.
Real quick, before I get into vacation talk, a couple weeks ago, we had Adam Neediff on the show. great guest.
Yeah.
Just a fantastic guest.
Yeah. And he likes Tudor's biscuits.
He loves Tudor's biscuits. Yeah. And he said publicly that he's coming back.
Is he?
He wants to come back.
Yeah.
Yeah. He had a great time on the show. And he mentioned something on his Facebook page, why he came on. Yeah. And one of his friends commented, she says, yeah, it was great. My favorite part of the show was when they actually let you talk.
We let him talk the whole time.
I thought we did.
Now,
yeah.
We have a problem. I have a problem with guests.
Staying on topic.
I don't.
Yeah. Remembering that we have a guest.
Yeah, yeah, I don't like to talk to the guests. But in general, mm-hmm. I think I've improved.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah.
When I listened to the Adam podcast, mm-hmm. episode 98, mm-hmm. go back and listen to
it
already.
Yeah.
I think it sounds like a good interview.
It was great. There was a guest on Letterman talking about doing a podcast or doing radio. Yeah. When you have a radio guest, you constantly say, our guest is Adam Neidiff. And I did that a few times.
Yeah.
I reminded people because they can't visually see him on an audio podcast.
You're like, so who is this guy?
I was proud of myself for that.
Yeah. Yeah. Is this Boobah? Who is this?
Yeah.
Irritable Dad Syndrome is brought to you this week by The Matchless Gene Rayburn by Adam Neidiff. It's a book, and it's a good book, too. The Matchless Gene Rayburn follows the career of one of America's favorite game show hosts before and after his days on The Match Game. Reading this book is guaranteed to make you blank. It doesn't matter what Old Man Periwinkle says. Order this and other game show books by Adam Neidiff at BearManorMedia.com. Now back to the show.
You went on vacation.
I did. I just got back from Hilton Head, South Carolina. Yeah. I love Hilton Head. We've been 4 years, 5 years in a row.
Yeah.
Hilton Head is a fantastic place. Great beach. Yeah. And every year we go, we rent bicycles and we ride all over the place.
And you go with your parole officer.
Yes, Teddy. Yeah.
Teddy, yeah. Okay.
Teddy, my parole officer,
but
goes.
You go with a fam. Like, there's other people in the family.
This year we did. Okay. Usually just the four of us. But this year we went. And Libby's brother, Eddie, who's a patron of our show. Thank you for your money,
Thank you, Eddie.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. His wife, Gina.
Thank you, Gina.
She's a fan of the show. Yeah, yeah. Their son, Ryan.
Thank you, Ryan. I'm all in right now.
We're going to do that.
All in. They got a dog?
No, they don't. Okay. They don't have a dog. Okay. And then Libby's sister came. And then Gina's sister. And her
mom. Who invited Gina's sister to this thing?
Gina's sister Lauren is awesome.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
Yeah.
How far does this family tree go? At what point do you say, you know what? We got enough people here.
There was 14 of us.
Good.
But now two condos.
Okay.
Two condos that were across the street from each other.
Yeah.
So it's not like we were all up in each other's business the whole time. So had a great time.
Okay.
And here's a beef. And this is going to be a just stop.
Okay.
For this. It's the just stop vacation edition.
Okay.
We stayed at a condo.
Yeah.
Okay. And we've stayed at
this. That's short for condominium.
Condominium. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's a BRB.
A VRB. Be right back.
Vacation rental BRBO.
Beach offers.
I have no idea.
Vacation rental beach office.
Vacation rental by owner. VRBO. It's a Vrbo.
Well, who the fuck else would rent it other than the owner?
I don't know. I don't know what it stands for. I'm going to edit all this stuff out.
Okay.
We're staying at this condo.
Yeah.
For a week.
Please don't edit this stuff out. This is comedy gold. Edit that out.
Four washcloths.
For the entire family?
For the entire family for the entire week. Now, there's laundry there.
Yeah.
And so that means that it's like we say the first night. That means day two, we have all wet washcloths.
Yeah.
Would it kill them? Washcloths aren't like pricey or anything.
No.
It's not like you're getting the Martha Stewart 2000, string cotton edition. Yeah. Buy some damn washcloths, load them up.
Yeah.
And then, but we're doing laundry every day. It's like, well, we don't have any washcloths to shower. So you got to throw in like the pool stuff, your wet swim trunks and whatever.
Cut up a towel.
Exactly.
We don't
have scissors.
Here's a thing that not many people know because they're not insane like I am,
yep.
but I know this for a fact. Uh-huh. In Brazil, they don't use washcloths. I don't know what website I was on. Mm-hmm. I don't know why I was there. I don't know what I was looking for, but there was an article and it said, by the way,
just so
it
you
was
know.
Like differences in different countries.
that hurt.
Yeah.
That noise I just made with my sinuses hurt.
it's different differences in the different countries
right.
and how they do things. And it was the big thing with Brazil is they don't use washcloths.
You know, I always imagined prison would be, you know, it's like all the guys have to use one loofah sponge.
I don't want to offend anybody.
Come on, that was funny. Come on, man.
I don't want to offend anyone.
Oh, now you don't want to offend.
But.
You offended me before we started, but you don't want to offend anybody now.
Okay, here's the thing. So, and this is not Mike Vacation Talk, so bear with me.
Okay.
We went to the desert. It's a dry heat.
Yeah.
It's a dry heat. You don't have swamp ass problems in a dry heat.
Yeah.
You have different problems.
Yeah.
You may not make it back from the mailbox.
Right.
But. You're not gonna be your balls are gonna be comfortable.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. Sure.
When you go to more humid zones like Florida is the realm of swamp ass.
Yeah.
You go to South America, it's very humid. There's a jungle. I don't know if you know this. Most rainforests in our hemisphere are in South America.
Yes.
I think you need washcloths down there.
You do.
I think if you're having issues with your crawl.
Yeah.
And by issues, I mean sweat.
Right, right.
I think you need to use a washcloth. I don't think the hand does it.
No.
No, I don't think just like aiming your junk at the shower head. I don't think that's going to do the job.
I know. You're right.
Things happen to your crack.
Way, now that you've said that, I don't think I'm going to Brazil.
I'm certainly not going to shake anyone's hand.
Yeah, no. No, I'm not.
It's time now for the Piggly Wiggly story of the week.
While we were down there, we did our grocery shopping at the Piggly Wiggly.
I love that there's Piggly Wiggly still in 2022.
I know. Well, I thought that there was only one left.
Yeah.
Turns out I think there's three left.
Are they like Blockbuster?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. But there's only three left, I believe. So don't go and check and then, you know, call and bitch that I'm wrong about this.
Is this a woke thing? Is it wrong to have a pig on a thing?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Anyway, the Piggly Wiggly is packing. I mean, it's just, this, good Lord.
Yeah.
Every time you go in there, it's like they're giving away free stuff.
Yeah.
But so you go into the Piggly Wiggly and I had not an incident, but it was close with the cashier. The guy in front of me had his things on the conveyor belt, or as you call it, the thing. And I put my things on the thing.
And
then I reached for the divider and put it down there, and she almost knocked it out of my hand.
What?
She grabbed it. She goes, no, it's okay. I got this. And she looked at me like, don't put that there.
Okay.
Or I'll cut you.
All right.
And I was like, okay.
All right. Okay.
Okay. So, dude buys his things,
right.
And then she starts ringing up my things, and the person behind me reaches for the divider. She almost knocks that out of his hand. She goes, I got this. Like, I've told you this before, even though she told me.
Yeah.
And apparently he was supposed to hear it through me.
Yeah.
Which
was she trying to prove something?
I don't know. What's wrong? It's like my God-given right. It's in the Constitution, right? I can use the plastic divider on the thing, on the conveyor belt.
There's things you expect when you go, like service-related items you expect. You go to the Piggly Wiggly, you want to get your put it on the thing, and pay for it and go.
Yeah.
I'm not impressed by somebody that doesn't need the divider. That's not a skill that I need the cashier to have.
Right. I know. Like, you walk out, like, can you believe she rang up all that stuff, and she didn't use the plastic divider?
I'm going to keep coming back to this place.
Oh, man. I'm telling all my friends.
Yeah.
And check out Renee or whatever her name was.
Yeah.
It didn't make any sense. Because if she doesn't want people to use it, why didn't she just throw it away? Why it's still there. Why is it? I know why it is. It's a control thing.
Yeah.
She wants somebody to get it so she can knock it out of their hand and say, no.
Yeah.
No.
She
bad has, customer.
She's
sit.
She's developed.
Roll over.
Yeah. She's developed this useless, unmarketable skill.
It's true.
And she wants to advertise it. Everybody, because nobody gives a
right.
Nobody is going to care one way or the other. But if she can continually,
and yet we're devoting a half hour of our podcast to it because nobody cares.
If she can keep berating people and doing that, then she's announcing she has it. Because at some point, someone who will value that skill more than Piggly Wiggly, say someone from Kroger, then maybe she could get a higher paying job.
Right.
Here's the deal: if you want a higher paying job or you want a job at Kroger, the fact that you are bagging anything,
it's a plus.
Boom, you could be hired. The manager.
No, I could just see that. Okay, so speaking of manager, like they have a position come open. yeah. at the Piggly Wiggly. And it's between John, the stock boy,
yeah.
and Renee, the cashier.
Who doesn't need those dividers.
Right, and they're going, yeah. you know what? Sorry, John, but she chose not to use the plastic divider. She's management material.
Yeah.
I don't think so.
I would have gone back to the Piggly Wiggly and moved from my order into the other order to see if she catches it.
I just said you had this, Renee. Part of me, if I wasn't in a hurry,
yeah.
part of me wanted to go, no, I want to use the divider.
Yeah.
I want to put it here because I don't want my stuff touching their stuff.
Yeah. Renee, this is my space.
Yeah.
This is my area.
Yeah.
Stay in your lane.
Right. And there are so few pleasures that you get from going to a grocery store. Right? Pushing the cart, especially if you get one that doesn't have a wobbly wheel.
Yeah.
Okay, that's always fun. I enjoy yeah. that. And then putting the divider on the conveyor belt thing.
Can I add on to your Just Stop?
Sure.
Did this start out as a Just Stop? This is going to be a really weird episode.
No, this isn't our Just Stop.
Okay. Yep. I don't think Kroger's going to be a sponsor of our podcast okay. because I've been poo-pooing them lately, and I'm uh-huh. going to poo-poo them again.
Okay.
The locking wheel, have you dealt with this situation? The locking wheel on mm-hmm. the shopping carts?
Uh-uh.
Most of the shopping carts have a wheel that locks. So if you go past the Kroger inventory control system and it goes off for whatever reason, it will lock the wheel of the cart.
What?
And the result of this is that you like, you know, have an issue. Well, the system was...
then you just grab your diet yeah. root beer and run.
Yeah, the system was screwed up for whatever reason, so I'm pushing a cart, and it does that, and I can't even push the cart anymore. So uh-huh. I have to take all the bags out of the cart, and I'm not going to talk to the person that's running up to me to right. see my receipt. I ain't right. got time for that.
Right.
I paid for my gummy bears.
Yeah.
I'm leaving.
Right.
Happened to another guy right in front of me. He had a full cart of stuff. He had to stop and have a conversation with him.
Uh-huh.
It's annoying.
Welcome back to Irritable Dad Syndrome. Back to the Piggly Wiggly.
Yeah.
You can, like I said, they're the only game in town. When yeah. you're on Hilton Head Island, that's the grocery
store. That's it.
Store.
You yeah. go to Piggly Wiggly.
There used okay. to be a Publix, Publix, but that place closed. I guess Piggly Wiggly run them out of business.
That lady,
yeah,
everybody exactly, heard about exactly. how she can.
She doesn't use the divider. We got to go there. Yeah. It's that damn divider woman, ain't it? She's taking all our business.
The Piggly.
Yeah, that's what she's doing. What's my point? Back to the Piggly Wiggly.
Yeah.
It's the only game in town. And you can go in there and you can buy Piggly Wiggly hats or shirts or sweatshirts. You can buy souvenirs, swag, as the kids call it.
Yeah. Can you buy a pig?
No, you can't buy a pig. You can buy ham or, you know, bacon. You can buy pig products, sausage.
A late pig.
Yeah. yeah. So while I was waiting on this woman to bag or to ring me up, my
yeah.
stuff.
Yeah.
I noticed there was a family of four walking in, man, woman, daughter, and the youngest was their son, all wearing matching Piggly Wiggly shirts. And I'm like, who farted?
Yeah.
Seriously? It's
discount.
Not the Hard Rock Cafe.
Yeah.
Do you win a contest?
Yeah.
If all it's like, hey, we all got our matching Piggly Wiggly shirts on. That's, okay. You know, what are you getting your pictures yeah. taken later?
Yeah.
I don't know. It didn't make any sense to me. And the final thing about the Piggly Wiggly was if you go to aisle 10, you know the thing that hangs from the ceiling, yeah. has all the stuff that's on there? Butt wipes. Butt wipes are on aisle 10.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking, you know what? You can say wipes.
Yeah.
And I think people know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can pretty much
And it's
wipe.
On the same aisle as the bread. Yeah. Bread and butt wipes.
I would say that anything you could wipe your butt with, you could wipe anything with. You know, if it can go on your butt, uh-huh. it can go just about anywhere. I mean, not after it's gone on your
this
butt.
This podcast is taking a turn for the worse. Yeah. Okay. All right. Yeah.
Can I point out that we had two viewers, now we have one, when you mentioned butt wipes?
This has been the Piggly Wiggly Story of the Week.
While Sorry. We were in Hilton Head,
yes.
the condo where we stayed that only had four washcloths,
uh-huh.
if you go through the back, the sliding glass door, there's a little pond, okay?
Oh.
A cute, adorable little pond,
yeah.
and you walk over the bridge and go to the pool
okay.
That closes at 10 p.m. At night, in Hilton Head, there and I've got audio of this that you haven't heard yet, but I'm going to play it, screeching frogs.
Screeching frogs.
There's like a gazillion frogs
okay.
in Hilton Head. And at night, that's all you can hear.
When you say screeching, is this a name you gave to the
yeah,
noise?
Now that I say screeching, that's probably I'm probably overdoing it a
little bit. Are they croaking?
Yeah.
Okay.
They're the croaking frogs. The screaming eels.
Yeah.
No. During the day, we went out through the sliding glass door, and I noticed that there was a turtle. Okay. And the turtle had somehow gotten out of the lake, the little pond.
Yeah.
Now there's like a wooden 6-foot drop that goes into the pond.
Okay.
I guess to keep people from going into the pond.
Okay.
Of course, once a family sees a turtle, everyone becomes a turtle expert.
Oh,
the turtle clearly wants to go back in the water. I'm like, what do you mean the turtle wants to go back in the water? How do you know? And everybody keeps calling him he.
That's like, not a turtle. That's a tarpon.
That's a tortoise right there.
That's a tortoise.
Yeah. And of course, and then my wife names him Larry. So everyone thinks the tortoise is a boy.
Not Leonardo, Donatello, Raphael. No.
Okay. Yeah. Everybody thinks the turtle is a boy, Larry.
Yeah.
And we're trying to figure out what we're going to do. And the turtle starts hauling ass the other way. Like, while these people are arguing, thinking that my name is Larry, I'm getting out of here.
Yeah.
And turtles can move.
Oh, okay. You get in one's crawl and they'll get out of there.
It's this thing about turtles being slow. He was hustling.
Yeah.
And he's going around. And then he did get on the edge, the wooden edge, like he was like looking over the side, like, I need to get back in the water. Yeah. But it's a haul to get down there, right? Yeah. So Jacob, my son, goes and picks up the turtle, and there was a place near the pool that had like a little rock walkway a little bit, and he put it down there, and Larry went back into the water, and then we were all thrilled and happy that Jacob saved a turtle on vacation.
Nice that Jacob saved a turtle.
I know, Jacob saved a turtle. Two other things about Hilton Head.
Okay.
Well, I found out that my feet smell horrible.
Yeah.
Oh my God. I'm wearing flip-flops or sandals. Flip-flops or sandals, that's all I'm wearing. A couple of weeks ago, I took off my flip-flops and realized that my feet smell like death. Okay. My feet smell like death took a inside a homeless man's gym sock. My feet smell horrible.
That's
And I'm pungent. Like, oh my God. Yeah. It's like, you know, in the cartoon when something smells really bad, you, like can, see
little
the,
wave,
you
can see like the Pepe waves. Like Pepe Le Pew had the little
exactly.
waves coming off.
Yeah. And I'm like, I can't go on a vacation with all these family members with my feet smelling like they smell.
Yeah.
So I bought some of that Funk Away. That's a real product, Funk Away. A spray to keep them from smelling like death.
Oh my God.
And now I'm trying to, it's like, what's wrong with me? It's like, I can't help that my feet smell this horrible.
Yeah.
Well, what am I supposed to do? Is there like a pill I can take?
Well, no.
Do I change my diet and that changes the smell of my feet?
No, I think all that's bullshit. At this point, I mean, at your age, who cares?
Yeah.
That's what I say.
Yeah.
Yeah. At my age, I don't care. My feet, my feet stink. My nose doesn't go that far, so I don't care.
Right.
You know, whatever.
Yeah, but when I'm sitting down, now, I can smell my feet.
Well, let me ask you this. Are you a person that takes a shower before you go to bed at night or when you wake up?
I take my shower in the morning.
I do it at night, so I will not get into the bed unless I am clean. Unless I'm like
nasty,
sick or something.
You go out and mow the grass.
Yeah.
You take a shower.
Yeah, shower. But I always, I just like slide down in there and I'm good.
Yeah.
And then I don't do anything in the morning. I just like.
You get up and go.
I pee and go.
Yeah.
See, I put clothes on.
I can't just get up and go. That's why I have to shower in the morning.
I don't wake up until I'm about 3/4 of the way to work.
Yeah.
It's like I just, holy sh**, what happened? I'm driving.
Hey, what happened?
That's what it used to be like when I was driving to WLWT every morning.
Yeah.
Falling asleep on 75 South.
We never talked about this. Yeah. I saw you one morning on the way to WLWT. We were almost next to each other for a while.
Good times.
129.
Yeah.
I didn't wave. I didn't honk.
No.
That
why,
was back
why would
when,
you?
That was back when I didn't really know who you were. All I knew about you was that your kid was Cameron.
Yes.
And you said some about you too. Right. That's the only two things I knew about you.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, all I know about you now is you only talk to me when we're doing the podcast. God forbid I try to call you.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you're calling me when I'm dying of COVID.
I was calling to see how you were doing.
I was dying of COVID.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't know you were dying of COVID.
Yeah.
I called.
Okay.
To
Bez told me that you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm not good at keeping up with people. I'm not. I'm a terrible. Yeah. You probably know this by now. I'm probably the worst friend you can. Because
you're like the best and worst friend I've ever had.
You gave me a present. You like gave me a present for my birthday. Like
I did
1 year.
Yeah, it was and I'm like, a Hobbit T-shirt.
Like, oh my God, what the f- do I do now? And Bess is like, well,
you say thank you.
and you may want to get him a present on his birthday. I was like, I've never gotten a friend a present. What do I get a friend? A necklace? What do I get him? I get you like stuff.
You got me the Billy Idol Funko Pop.
I did. It took a long time. Like I went to, I told her, I'm going to everybody's records.
Uh-huh.
I know I'll find something for him there. And then I saw the Billy Idol Funko Pop. By the way, speaking of Funko Pops, this is also not on the rundown.
No, it's not.
There is finally
the U2.
The U2.
Where Bono Funko looks like Pop, Roy Orbison.
And Bono is, they have one where Bono's in a Trabant in the car from the Octung Babies. And I lost my laughing at them because I think most people.
At all.
It looks just like
Bono. Most Funko Pops don't look like the. People.
They have like they're caricatures. They're caricatures. Yeah. Nobody has like big black eyes.
It's a stretch. Yeah.
It looks just like Bono did in the Zoo TV.
Yeah.
And what cracked me up about it is that the Bono one is doing the Bono, one of the Bono poses with the microphone. Uh-huh. One of the things he's kind of known for. I'm a dork. I know this. And everybody's like, what is he talking about? Just shut up.
And Bono, well, I'll tell you what he's getting ready to say. He's ready to go.
Yeah. Okay. So, and then. And then you got Edge posing with a guitar, and then you got Adam posing with the bass guitar. Larry's just standing there holding the drumsticks, and he literally looks like he's saying, how do I do with these things?
Yeah.
And that cracks me up because that's kind of Larry's attitude in the band.
Did you buy the Funko Pops?
I bought all of them.
Yes.
Pre-ordered them, and I got the one with Bono and the Trabant. The real question is, do I open them? And the answer is going to be no. But I am going to buy the one that they're releasing to Walmart with all four of them together, and I may play with them.
Suck it.
They may appear on the show at some point.
Okay.
Yeah. Good times.
One last thing about Hilton Head. I mentioned that we always rent bicycles.
Okay.
We rent bicycles, and we ride them all around Hilton Head, and we have a blast. Mm-hmm. One morning, Libby and I went on a bike ride together.
Okay.
This is the most fun that she and I have had together in a very long time.
Yeah.
And we usually have fun when we go out on dates. We go to movies, whatever. We had a blast. The common thing to do is, like in Avengers, if you're riding your bike and you are about to pass somebody on your left, and then you pass them on your left. Okay. We're riding our bikes. Libby's ahead of me, not a fair piece, but a little bit, probably 10 feet ahead of me. And the man and woman who are walking on the trail, they walked in the grass. They like kind of moved over into the grass. Libby didn't feel the need to say, on your left.
Yeah.
So she passes the woman. Yeah. The woman shoots Libby this look, and she goes, passenger on your left, which twitched Libby's like, what, you know? Yeah. And then, like I said, I'm 10 feet behind. I come up and I say, good morning. And the husband says, good morning. And we keep going. And I can just imagine.
Oh, he heard that. He heard about it when he got home.
You're going to say good morning after she damn near run over me?
Yeah.
What in the hell's wrong with you, Ed? These people coming up, they walk all over you like you're a damn carpet.
Yeah.
And now I'm sunburnt. You know how I get when I'm sunburnt, you know? And I can just imagine her bitching
it's
at him.
It's the couple in the Hobbit where the guy's laughing at the fireworks.
Exactly.
And then the lady Hobbit is behind him just like staring
Libby
at him.
Libby clearly pissed this woman off.
Yeah.
And then this guy was just like welcoming us over for dinner and drinks.
Yeah.
Yeah, because he has no spine.
Yeah, I've been biking. That's my new thing.
Yeah.
Is I've been biking in Sharon Woods. And I never say on your left because I don't want to talk to people.
Right.
I just try to sneak my way. I figure you can hear a freaking bike. I've been going to Sharon Woods for like 15 years.
Well, with you, you can hear your heavy breathing.
Yeah. And the number of people who are absolutely shocked that someone is using the bike path.
Yeah.
It just blows my mind.
Mm-hmm.
And one lady felt the need to yell out at me, I didn't hear you. And what makes that one especially nice for me was she was walking with what I can assume was her daughter or her very much younger sister.
Uh-huh.
They both were walking a dog. The sister slash daughter turned around and saw me.
Yeah.
Both dogs looked around. And, you know, just... She is not looking around at all. And I go off the road a little bit, off the path, and she jumps like I'm the guy from Scream, the ghost face guy.
Yes.
She jumps.
Yeah.
And then feels the need to yell, like I said, I didn't hear you.
Uh-huh.
Whatever. I also come in the other way. I go about the same time when I go every on the days that I go. So I kind of see kind of the same people.
Uh-huh.
There is a couple with a dude.
Uh-huh.
Who has some problem with bikers on the path.
Yeah.
And they go around. Everybody kind of has their favorite way around this path.
Yeah.
I like to go from the fishing deck around back towards the playground. That's my path. All right. They go the other way. So we're always facing each other. This dude feels the need to actively not get over when I'm riding the other way. He will walk in the middle of the path. And he's got his arm swinging, and I've seen him do it a couple of times. He swings his arm out a little bit out, like he's trying to hit my handlebar.
Like he's trying to clip
me. So it'll be like one of those things, like he'll clip me, and it'll be like, oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean it, and it'll knock me off the thing, because I'm always going a little bit off the path.
Yeah.
And he and I have got, we're on this, here's the stage we're on, and I hope he's a listener.
I doubt it.
He's probably not. We're at the stage where we've seen each other enough to where when we see, I see him and I'm coming down the path, we're just staring at each other. And I'll see him shift over 6 to 8 inches. It's subtle. And I'm like, one of these days,
let's do it. This,
boom, bam. And knock him right in the pond.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Do it.
And then it's going to stare at his wife until she walks away.
See what I did? Yeah. See what I did?
See what happens?
Yeah. Yeah.
See what happens?
That's what you get.
Yeah. I'm out of shape. I'm out of shape and I'm fat. But I'm younger than you are, and I can knock your ass in the pond and hold my own.
Yeah. Before we were finished with our bike ride, again, we had a blast. Libby pulls her bike over and gets off, and I stopped, and she looks at me and goes, sorry, I had to take a butt break. Not realizing that behind me was another biker who passed right the second she said, I had to take a butt break.
Those things hurt your butt.
They do.
You're not used to them.
I know they do. Yeah. Then you got to go to the Piggly Wiggly and get your butt wiped.
Irritable Dad Syndrome is proud to be associated with Newsly, the all-in-one audio super app for iOS and Android. For the first time ever, the entire internet becomes listenable, all in one place. Newsly picks up articles about the most trending topics and reads them to you in a natural human voice. Irritable Dad Syndrome is available there, too. You can find trending podcasts from more than 80 countries and digital radio as well. So stop scrolling and start listening. Download Newsly now. Just go to www.newsly.me and use this promo code 1RR1TABLEDAD and receive a free 1 month premium subscription.
So you had some unwelcome visitors.
We had a war.
Yeah.
We had a let's just call it what it is, Darren. We had a war.
Okay.
I look out the window.
Yeah.
And I see Bess is talking to one of our neighbors, which is odd because we don't really talk to our neighbors. I'm like, what the hell's going on out there? And Bess comes in and says, we have a problem. What?
Mm-hmm.
We have
the HOA bees. Is complaining about the in the tree.
Yeah. By the way, if we lived in a neighborhood with an HOA, we would be kicked. It would be like pitchforks and torches.
Yeah. Thank God you don't have an HOA.
So she said, we have bees in this tree and they stung this lady like twice. I'm like, oh my Lord, that's terrible.
Right.
Because bees die when they sting somebody. So I bet two dead bees now.
Yeah. We'll have to bury them and everything.
So I go out there and I'm looking around and I see like some buzzing things around.
Mm-hmm.
And then I realize my face mm-hmm. is about 8 to 10 inches away from a wasp nest, a large one.
Mm-hmm.
I just didn't see it. And I look and there's a wasp like at the entrance, and he's got this look at it on his waspy eyes. Like
it's going down.
You ready? You coming?
Yeah, let's go.
Right? And I back away, and I remember saying, and I quote, oh. And I I backed into the street. This is how, because you know where our tree, I backed into the street. I didn't care what hit me. That thing was right near my face. So I'm like, okay, we got to deal with this.
Yeah.
I go back in, and I tell her, these are not bees. These are wasps from the pit of hell. Mm-hmm. It's okay to kill these things.
Right.
Bees, you don't want to mess with bees because I've read all the articles at like 2 a.m. that tell you if we lose all our bees, then somehow everyone on the planet dies.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know what I'm talking about. Google, bees die. We all die.
Right.
And you'll be up until 3 a.m.
Right.
Anyway, I'm looking at ways to do this. It says one, call a beekeeper. F*** off. Second one's call an exterminator. I'm not calling an exterminator.
Right.
Third one is go find chemicals at Home Depot. So I go to Home Depot. I get some chemicals.
Depot. There's no S in Depot.
We call it Home Depot.
Okay.
I get the one that says soak the nest with this 27-foot spray. It says do it at night because bees and wasps are less active at night.
Right.
So I post a warning to everyone. Bess decided she wants to put a sign out there that says, hey, there's things in here that can sting you.
Okay.
So she said, should I put a sign out there? I think implied in that was, do you want to put a sign out there?
Right.
And I replied, yeah, you can put a sign out there if you like.
Yeah.
So she did. She got stung twice.
Oh,
it's terrible. So anyway, I decide we're going to go out at night and we're going to take this thing down. You dutifully posted on Facebook, don't believe this. They don't sting at night bullshit.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, that's what they said on Duck Dynasty.
Okay. So I told them, it's like 3 o'clock and I'm getting antsy. I want to take these things down. Or I'm sorry, about 1 o'clock. I'm getting antsy.
Uh-huh.
I tell Beth, I'm just going to go ahead and go out there and get them. She's like, no, we got to wait till night. These things are going to kill you. I was mm-hmm. like, they're going to, I want to be able to run from them when it's daylight.
Right.
Okay. I can make it back to the house. The last thing you need is someone running, screaming from wasps and tripping and dying on our doorstep. Then what are you going to do? You get a dead husband and a bunch of pissed off wasps.
Right.
So, and Charlie, he heard mm-hmm. daddy's going to go out and destroy the wasp nest. So he got really excited mm-hmm. and he recorded the video on his iPad.
Yeah,
and
it was great.
So basically, guys, my dad. So basically, there is a wasp nest in our tree. We have two trees in our front yard, and there's a wasp nest in one of them. And my dad is about to go destroy it with, the wasp spray. And he's covering up all his body parts so he doesn't get stung by a wasp. And so I'm going to videotape it. I don't know why, but sure.
The basic what happened is I go out, okay, and I'm standing what I consider to be a respectable distance away from the wasps. Charlie is over there filming me.
He's not filming you.
He's
recording.
He's taping me.
He's not taping you.
He's recording me.
He's recording. There's no tape in your damn phone.
He's recording. He's taping me with film.
Uh-huh.
And I'm thinking, there's this weird thing in my brain. I don't know. It's since I've gotten older, it's kind of taken over the thing. I just do things.
Yeah.
And I'm looking at it. I'm like, yeah, I think I need. Okay. And I raised up and I just started spraying.
Uh-huh.
And I think I told you before we came down, I saw one or two wasps come out and they start circling around. And I'm like, I think I could handle one or two wasps. And then a couple more came out and I run away. I run to the door. Anyway,
right.
Long story short, I soaked this thing. Uh-huh. I felt bad. I still feel bad about it because I basically killed a whole colony of wasps.
They're dangerous.
Yeah. And they did.
It's not like they're an endangered species.
And they did attack a random woman in our neighborhood.
Yeah.
And they attacked Bess and got her.
They started it. You finished it.
Yeah. Anyway, so we took them down.
Yeah.
They're down. I'll post the video. Like I said, you can see the whole thing.
Irritable Dad Syndrome was brought to you this week by Diff Liquid Concentrated Wallpaper Stripper. With its unique enzyme action, Diff dissolves old paste and cuts wallpaper removal time in half. Hi, I'm Dave Lay. Summer is upon us, and it just keeps getting hotter and hotter. There's no better time to stay inside in an air-conditioned home with some cold beer and a bottle of Diff. While everyone else is outside sweating their butts off, you can be inside where it's nice and cool and remove some of that nasty wallpaper you've been staring at since 1994. So what are you waiting for? Pick up a case at your corner hardware store and get stripping with Diff.
I mentioned at the top of our show that my son had his wisdom teeth pulled out.
Uh-huh.
And everyone, Libby, Cameron, myself, we're all in agreement. I'm going to get as much... I'm going to record as much of him as I possibly can.
Is this going to be another video that pops up on the...
Well, I was going to post the video, but his mouth and his teeth were very bloody and gross.
Oh.
So I didn't. But
okay.
The audio is hysterical. Okay. Because I went back. They said, Mr. Cox, Jacob, he's done with recovery. I walk into the back room. Hi, Dad. Hi, Dad. Hi. He's waving.
Yeah.
He's like, Dad, hi. Yeah. Hey, Dad. I'm like, hey, buddy. And then he's like, my mouth feels really gross. I'm like, yeah, I know. Yeah. And he starts to put his fingers in his mouth to touch. And the lady's like, oh, but buddy, you can't do that. That's gross. And so what does he do? He goes, okay, I'm sorry. I won't put my fingers in my mouth. And then he turns to the side. Slowly, like no one's watching. Yeah. He's going to sneak and put his fingers in his mouth. We're like, dude, no, don't do that. And so the doctor goes through the whole thing. You know, it's like, you know, ibuprofen and then Tylenol and back and forth for pain. And, you know, all the things about he can eat, you know, Frosties and soups and that type of thing. And not to swish and not to brush the first day. All that stuff that you're supposed to do. And anyway, I got him in the car and he was disappointed that it didn't last longer. And he kept saying it was going to last longer.
Yeah.
And, and I called my wife. He's like, hi, mom. He's waving at her.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. She's on the phone. He's waving. It was just great. And we're in Hamilton. The dentist office was in Hamilton, Ohio.
Okay. Right.
And we're driving past. And there's this building, and I don't know if it was a Red Cross or what the building was, but it had a red, like a plus on it and a wolf. And Jacob's like, Dad, I had my teeth pulled. There's a wolf. That's a wolf. That's a wolf, Dad.
Yeah.
It's a wolf. I'm like, I know.
Yeah.
And I'm driving.
Yeah.
And I'm like so mad because he like this golden material here, and I can't record him while I'm driving. Traffic's bad.
Yeah.
And then it's like we got to a red light and I got my phone out and then he stopped talking about the wolf.
Yeah.
But, anyway, he's recovering fine. But man, have your video camera ready if your friend or loved one gets their wisdom teeth removed because it's a blast. It's time for us to retire another song.
Yeah.
And this week's song
is controversial.
Because it's from one of my all time favorite artists.
And I don't dislike the song.
You had mentioned this, and I was like, no, I don't want to do this. But the more you actually persuaded me.
So
this week's song that we're retiring.
Yeah. I first heard this song. It's on the Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas soundtrack.
Uh-huh.
And I actually played it as we were going into Vegas during our trip.
Uh-huh.
And it's one of those things you never really listen to the lyrics that closely.
Right.
But once you do, it's like, oh.
Yeah. Why don't you tell people the title of this week's song?
It's one of those songs. I never really listened to the lyrics.
Is this our first episode?
Hold on. I'll get there. I just want to give you something so you can edit all that out.
Okay.
So it's a song, She's a Lady.
Yeah.
By Tom Jones.
Yeah.
It's a cool song.
It's a great song.
Terrible for... Now, James Caan died.
Yes. Broke my heart.
Yeah. I love James Caan.
Yeah.
In my head, he sang this song.
James Caan's song.
In my mind, I know Tom Jones sang it, but when I imagine someone singing it, it's always James Caan.
James Caan can't sing his way out of a bucket.
Well, it doesn't matter.
He can't. Now
it doesn't
he's dead.
Matter. It doesn't
but,
matter. It doesn't matter.
But yeah.
In my head, he was singing the song. So I want to go through the lyrics.
Okay.
Because I don't think people listen to the lyrics. Everyone knows the music.
Right.
Okay.
Well, she's all you'd ever want.
She's the kind they'd like to flaunt and take to dinner. Well, she always knows her place. Whoa.
Oh, hello.
Hmm. Mm. She's got style. She's got grace.
There
He's
you
go. Kind of saving himself.
She's a
winner.
She's a winner.
Yeah.
She's a lady. Whoa. She's a lady.
I know you've been practicing that in the mirror for like a week.
I've got a natural gifted golden voice.
Talking about that little lady. Uh-huh. And the lady is mine.
Yeah.
Okay, it's on the edge.
Right.
On
right.
the edge.
There we go.
Now we're like, well, she's never in the way.
Uh-huh.
What?
I hate when my wife gets in my way.
Yeah. And always something nice to say. Oh, what a blessing.
Uh-huh.
I can leave her on her own. Really? She's not like a...
Not like an 8-year-old. I went to work, came back, damn wife, and set the house on fire.
But then he clarifies in the next line. He says, knowing she's okay alone,
uh-huh.
And then he says, there's no message. And so there's what he's no saying, message. You can leave her and she's not going to go bang other guys.
Right.
But, I mean, there's a problem with this relationship already. You can't leave the house.
Right.
What he's saying is, I can leave the house. And she's not going to go bang another dude.
Is that a compliment?
I don't know.
Is that really and a compliment?
She's a lady. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Go ahead. Right. Do your.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. She's a lady. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
She's a lady. Here's where I get concerned. Well, she never asks for very much, and I don't refuse her.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Always treat her with respect. I never would abuse her.
Right.
You talk about a low bar. Right. I love this woman. I would not beat the shit out of her.
Look, Chris Rock, you're not supposed to beat the shit out of her. You're not supposed to be abusing her.
What she's got is hard to find, and I don't want to lose her.
Uh-huh.
Help me build a mountain from my little pile of clay. I don't know Hey, hey, hey.
Yeah.
well, she knows what I'm about. She can take what I dish out, and it's not easy.
That's not easy.
What the hell's going on in this household?
Right. I don't know.
Well, she knows me through and through. She knows just what to do and how to please me. It's a lady, all that
bull. Whoa, whoa, whoa. She's a lady.
Yeah. And then it goes on, and it's just repeats of all the things here. But, this one goes really... See, this is 2022, Darren.
Uh-huh.
I don't know if you know that.
Paul Anka wrote the song.
Okay.
Yeah.
For some reason, what's the guy's name in MASH?
Alan Alda?
Yeah. You said Paul Anka. I thought of Alan Alda. What? Now I'm imagining Alan Alda singing the song. My point is... This song skirts right on the edge of we're in the land of woke. We're in the woke culture now.
Right.
All right. And so Bill Burr does an awesome bit on his new special about how we really shouldn't be saying woke.
Right.
I highly recommend everyone watch anything Bill Burr has ever done.
His Red Rocks special dropped today on Netflix. That's what the kids say. It dropped today.
And he has a thing on woke. And I was cracking up.
You know,
anyway, the point is.
Paul Anka also wrote the theme song for The Tonight Show.
Okay.
There you go.
And this is very similar to The Tonight Show theme song.
Yeah.
Except this has less womanizing than The Tonight Show theme song. It's just, there's some songs out there that you love the sound of, but then if you really listen to the lyrics, it's
interesting.
Yeah. Whoa, 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 she's a lady. Like Raining Blood by Slayer. The music is...
That is the song about the chocolate chip cookies?
No.
That was Tool.
It's an upbeat. It's got upbeat tempo.
But when you really listen to the lyrics,
it's got some...
Yeah, Slayer didn't do any ballads that I know of.
They got some little devilish influences.
Okay.
I'm just saying.
Yeah. Speaking of devil, speaking of the devil,
yes,
I was in Kroger, and I walking past their the crowbar in their wine section. There's a bottle of wine called the Velvet Devil. I'm like, seriously? Who's... Hey, honey,
this sounds like a high tier dildo.
Exactly. It does.
I'll take the Velvet Dildo.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, honey, you pour me another glass of that Velvet Devil. I mean, really? Would you care for some Velvet Devil? What, the cork? It's like, come on.
I want someone to make a Western where someone walks in and tells everyone they're the Velvet Devil, and the whole saloon just busts out laughing.
Make it Chris Pratt. It's got to be Chris Pratt.
He said his name is the Velvet Devil.
I'm the Velvet Devil.
That's great.
Oh,
oh,
oh, she's a lady. Oh, man. Well, listen, we're going to wrap this episode up. I want to mention, this is our 99th episode.
Yeah.
The next episode we record, Do the Math, will be... By the way, I hate when people say do the math. You do the math. Because I hate doing math. Yeah.
Yeah.
Our next episode is going to be our 100th episode.
Yeah.
Jim Timmerman.
Okay.
Big fan of the show.
Planking with Timmerman.
Planking with Jim. He is going to take the video... Okay, we record this show on the Twitch.
Yeah.
Every Tuesday. This week we're doing it on Wednesday. Sorry, we're a day late.
And then I post the videos on Patreon.
Right.
So I scrub them from Facebook. So when we go live, let's a little aside here. When we go live, we go live on Facebook, Twitch, all YouTube. It's all there.
Yeah.
I scrub them from those sites and I put them on Patreon.
Yeah.
So if you want to see our videos from our previous episodes, they're all there.
Yeah. We put it on Grindr, right? Oh, oh, oh,
she's a lady. And we're in the Velvet Devil section.
Yeah, we're in the Velvet Devil.
Yeah.
What Jim Timmerman has offered to
do. Going to be the title of this episode.
This is going to be fantastic.
Okay.
The video is going to be unedited. Okay.
Yeah.
But what he's going to do is make a pop-up video of the live video recording, and it will be available for our patrons.
Yeah.
How can you be a patron? That's a good question, Mike. Go to irritabledadsyndrome.com. Go to Patreon. Okay.
Yeah, there's a link right there.
You can donate $1 a month. You can donate a little bit more. Okay. You
did, like, merch and stuff.
Exactly.
Like that.
You can buy merchandise. You can listen to previous episodes of Irritable Dad Syndrome.
Yeah.
You can buy Whompers, all beef, foot long hot dogs, beach towels.
Oh, I forgot we have those.
Yeah, we got all that cool stuff on irritabledadsyndrome.com. Anyway, if you're gonna want to watch this pop-up video thing, which you are, you're gonna have to be a patron to do it. So go to irritabledadsyndrome.com, go to Patreon. Set it up, donate $1 a month, and then you can enjoy this pop-up goodness, courtesy of Jim Timmerman.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I don't know why I'm thinking you.
I assumed that you were thinking Jim.
I'm thinking Jim.
Yeah. So thanks, Jim.
Thanks, Jim.
Anywho, we're going to wrap this one up. When we see you next week, it'll be our 100th episode.
Holy.
I've got so much editing because you won't stop saying and I just did it again.
Guys, a brief aside.
On the eve of episode 100.
Because when archaeologists find this podcast years from now, they're going to go right into episode 100. So I just want to take a breather here.
Mm-hmm.
Let's reflect.
Okay.
Way back when we did episode 8. Remember episode 8? It was our comeback episode.
Yes.
Because we ended the podcast on episode 7.
And some bonehead thought that we really went off the air. And he didn't find out till like 90 episodes later or something.
Yes. That was considered the soft cutoff for podcasts.
Most podcasts
don't make it past seven episodes.
Yeah. Right.
And then we made it past that. And I was just telling you, just before we came down here, someone I know had started a podcast and they just kind of stopped.
Right.
And that makes me sad.
I know.
And so, but we're on the edge of 100 freaking episodes.
And granted, there's an asterisk because there were two episodes that we repeated.
Yeah.
And
we just don't repeat.
I know.
We do some
We added a new open and a close. We threw some other things in there. So we gave people a reason to listen. So technically, and then our episode 52 was our 1 year anniversary special.
Yeah. And 104 we're doing.
And 104 we're doing our 2 year anniversary special.
Which is going to be amazing.
It's going to be on fleek. It's going to be penultimate. You're going to you're going to want to take a butt break if you listen to it. It's
I created a file and Darren created a file. We've been picking our best bit and most of the things we agree on.
Yeah.
There's some funny.
Yeah.
There is. So.
And let me mention this because I was going to mention it in episode 104.
Yeah.
But it's not really a best of thing. I don't remember what episode it was, but we did a thing where we listened to a song called Evil Evil.
Yeah.
It Turns Me On.
Evil Evil.
And we played almost the entire song.
Uh-huh.
I would have bet all the money I had that within a week, someone would have written to us.
Yeah.
Or one of my neighbors would have come up and said, what the heck was that? Nobody.
Just crickets.
Not one person said a thing about Evil Evil. Yeah. It Turns Me On. One of the craziest songs of all time, which made me like, people listen to the episode.
Yeah.
People listen to every episode that we had.
Yeah.
But nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Yeah.
So I was going to devote some time to on episode 104, and I've decided not to do that.
Okay.
It's going to be because it's going to be the best.
Yeah.
All right. We're going to shut up. We'll see you next time on Irritable Dad Syndrome.
Well, that does it for us this week. Time to hit the open road and ride off in the sunset. Adios.
Jacob's going to kill me, but here's some audio of him after he had his wisdom teeth removed. So, Jacob, you got your wisdom teeth pulled out. How you feeling?
I'm feeling pretty good.
Yeah.
The lady said that I was being gross.
Mm-hmm.
So I was putting my hand down.
Yeah, you can't put your finger down on your tongue.
Oh.
Okay. But you're feeling pretty good?
Yeah.
Were they nice?
They were nice. The lady was I think she was annoyed with me he wouldn't stop putting my hand in my mouth. Or did he?
Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, you can't put your hand in your mouth.
I don't know. I'm kind of disappointed because I thought it would be a lot longer.
Yeah?
And I wanted to be there longer.
You wanted to be there longer?
Yeah.
You want me to take you back inside?
Yeah, let's go back inside.
Close the door. All right, I'm going to go get you a Frosty, okay?
Yay. Frosty.
Love you, buddy. Happy 18th birthday.
This should not be on an audio podcast, right. But then I realized I didn't care.